time to discuss it. It's very interesting in physics. The third mode. So this guy, which is very slow, right? It's very, very slow. Actually, sometimes it goes the other way around and becomes unstable. It's very typical to see it unstable. But still, it's very slow, because the settling time is 4 divided by the real part. So it's very slow, so actually, even if it's unstable, pilots are not pissed off. It's fine. They can recover the airplane fine. What's this mode? It's called the spiral mode. So this is the blue mode. Now we go to the spiral mode. Hopefully, I'll have time to discuss it. It's very interesting business. Going quickly, I'll go jump to the eigenvector. Okay. Here is its eigenvector. So the eigenvector is 648. It is 0.0292, negative 4009, 0.0167, and 1. And if you included the fifth state psi that we have been neglecting so far, remember this is beta side slip, roll kind of thing, yaw rate, and roll angle. And this is the yaw angle that we have been neglecting. Just include it to see what's going on here. As it said, it's a hard mode, it's not, the eigenvector is not very clear to tell the story. So let's see. Side slip is very weak, roll is very weak. These are the aerodynamic variables. Beta, P, and R. This is the aero. And these guys are the inertial angles of the airplane. This is inertial with horizontal and stuff. But this is aerodynamics. So comparing the aerodynamic stuff with the most significant guy is the roll, it's the yaw rate. R is the, right? R and beta, maybe. The same here, if you compare roll and yaw, yaw is much larger than roll. So from this comparison, it's not very clear what happens, but it might be reasonable to think about R as an approximation. Remember, this is one eigenvalue, it's a very hard choice. One eigenvalue, at the end of the day, I need one equation. So the R equation is actually nv times v plus Np times P plus Nr times R. Okay? Okay, if we decide to take the yaw, so this is okay, this is okay. What should I do with these two things? First of all, I cannot ignore them completely. I cannot say this is zero, and then I will get R dot equals something times R. It's as if x dot equals ax. So this would be my A, which is the same eigenvalue. This is 0.76. Has nothing to do with the 0.009 something for the eigenvalue. It doesn't represent the eigenvalue by any means. We need to do something clever. And actually, this is still under research. What's the best approximation for the spiral mode? It's not. We don't have best approximation. We have something that is reasonable. So for sure I will retain this, and I need to deal with these two guys. And the suggestion that the community came up with is the following. I can ignore one of them, say P, and use the P equation, use the P dynamics to get V, to solve for V and come it back here. So in this sense, I ignored P, but used its dynamics. So it's as if I accounted for it in some sense. and I did not neglect this guy. So this was the suggestion that here is the B equation, P dot equals LV times V, LP times V, plus LR times R. So if I neglected the P, and I solve this equation in V, then I can substitute V here, and I'm done. I have a single equation in R. R dot equals NV dash times V. What is V? It's LR over LV times R plus the other term. So at the end of the day, here is the single equation. I'll just drop the dashes, okay, for the moment. So this is, where is that? Okay. NR times LV minus, the other way around, NV times LR, all over LV times R. This is our most reasonable approximation for the spiral motor. And if you substitute by numbers, you'll get, this is a first order system. X dot equals something times X. So this whole bracket is your A matrix. It's a single number. So the eigenvalue is the same as the number. So lambda spiral is equal to this thing. NRLV, and you can always do the following. You can say VVV, I will replace them all with beta, as if dividing by U naught everything. Minus N beta LR over L beta. And this is, in this example, is negative 0.16 versus 0.01 or something. So it's not very accurate, but it's the best that we can get. But more importantly, it's actually representing the physics, and we're going to see why. It's representing the physics. Let's see why. Any questions so far? Any questions so far? So we have an analytical expression for the lambda of the spiral model. Very approximate, not exact by any means. Any questions? So let's see now the physics. We learned before about NR LV, which is L, this is L beta, NR L beta, N beta, this is new thing, we did not deal with it before, right? I had it in the lecture notes, but we did not discuss it in class. LR, what's that? Let's see what's LR. First of all, just a quick review how to derive these things. So the disturbance is R, it's a rotation about Z. So I draw the XY plane. So this is X body and Y body. This is your wing, Y wing. And we apply R. Here is R. Okay. An angular velocity. What happened to a station like this at the distance y? This r will cause it to move backward with a velocity omega times the distance. So omega is r and the distance is y. But it was moving forward before with a velocity u naught, correct? So it's as if this wing station is flying with a lesser speed. On the other hand, I have this guy moving with u naught plus r y. So the velocity here increase, the velocity here decrease. If the velocity increase, what will happen to the left? The velocity increase, what will happen to the left? Increase. So I have a larger lift here, and I have a smaller lift there. So the airplane will roll. So here it is. This is your thing. Wing. On the left wing, I have larger lift. This guy has smaller lift. Okay? So the airplane will roll to the right. Positive. So LR is positive. And actually the CLR expression that we derived in, it's derived in the lecture notes, we did not discuss it in class, CL over 6, CL of the airplane has to do with the lift coefficient, because there's no change in the angle of attack. This is the first time to see change in the speed. Things happening due to change in the speed, not angle of attack. So it's the same angle of attack, 1 plus 3 lambda over 1 plus lambda. So as you can see, it's positive. The lift coefficient of the airplane is positive. Please bear with me for the coming few minutes. And you will have the notes, you don't need to write. Lambda is the taper ratio, everything is positive, this is positive. This stability derivative is destabilizing. It's destabilizing. Why? Because what we're saying the airplane is disturbed by R, a yawing angular velocity. We're saying that this yawing angular velocity will naturally cause a rolling moment, right? This yaw is to the right. The rolling moment coming out of that is also to the right. So the airplane is yawing. And naturally, what will happen? A roll moment will occur to the right. So what will happen? Well, I have a yaw to the right, roll to the right, so I'm just going all the way, right? So this is destabilized. You will not be in cruise anymore. You will depart from cruise, okay? So this stability derivative is destabilizing. That's okay. So now we know almost everything here, and I will review them with you now, but at least we know what you mean by CLR. This is the CLR effect. This is the eigenvalue. For stability, I need this eigenvalue, positive or negative? Anybody doesn't agree that it has to be negative? So this lambda for stability, for stability, this lambda spiral should be negative, okay? So this whole thing should be negative. The L beta, do you remember the L beta is positive or negative? This L beta is positive or negative? No, this L beta is negative. If you ever stuck, just say negative, because the chance to be correct is much more. The only guy is positive in this whole dilemma is this guy. Everything is negative, okay? So anyway, L beta is negative. If I need the entire thing to be negative, this means that the numerator has to be positive, okay? You divide positive by negative to get negative. So the numerator has to be positive. This implies following. Implies that NR L beta has to be larger than N beta LR. And this is what we get out of the approximation, the crude approximation. But it helps us to scrutinize the flight physics a little bit. Anybody doesn't agree with this identity? I need this inequality to be satisfied for the stability of the spiral motor. What is this guy? This is what we just described. So this guy is positive. N beta is your Weatherproof stability. This is the yaw stiffness. Yaw stiffness. And it's positive. It's due to vertical tail. Okay? What about L beta? It's due to a bunch of things that we just discussed. And it's negative, it's roll stiffness. Rolling moment due to an angle. Yaw moment due to an angle. Dihedral sweep, blah blah. This is vertical tilt. What's this? NR, what's NR? What's NR? What's the name of NR, the official name of NR? Is it damping or stiffness or something else? Come on. So this is very important. We cannot move forward. You have to tell me. I mean, these are the important things that are coming out of this class. This guy is what? Well, what is N, first of all? What's N? Yeah. Yawing what? moment. Yeah. What's R? Your angular velocity, your rate, omega. Okay? What's this guy? Is it stiffness or damping? Spring or damping? What's the difference between spring and damping? The spring gives you force proportional to what? Spring. Force or moment, doesn't matter, proportional to what? Displacement. Okay? Not velocity. The damper gives you force or moment proportional to velocity. So this is your moment. This is your rate. Velocity. A moment due to velocity. So this is what? It's your damping. Okay. So your damping, and it's due to the vertical tail size also. Okay. So this mode, this approximation says that if this guy is larger, these guys are larger than the other two, the spiral will be unstable. The spiral will be unstable. Let's see that. When the airplane is slipping, this is a little bit of V. I need two actions actually to happen. I need two actions. This is slipping. This is in the yaw direction. The velocity of the airplane, this is a little v, this is y, this is x. This is either y, this is z. So this guy is slipping like this. I need roll, if the airplane is slipping to the right, I need rolling moment in what direction? To the right or to the left? I need rolling moment to the left. This is why L beta is negative. Why I need roll to the left? If the airplane is slipping like this, I need roll to the left so that my left force now is pointing into that direction. So it will be opposing to the initial slip, side slip speed. With this rate, eventually I will stop. I will stop slipping, okay? So again, slipping into that direction, I need the airplane to naturally do like this. This is stabilizing action. And what is the main guy responsible for it? It's L beta. On the other hand, here in this picture, if the airplane is slipping with little v, I need a yawing moment. To the right or to the left? Here. You need the airplane to yaw.